Hello, chicken people. Welcome to the Hobby Farm Guys. I'm Brian, and today I'll spotlight a beautiful, true Bantam chicken breed, the Dutch Booted Bantam, or Sable Poot. Stay tuned to learn all about this magnificent little bird. As in the case with many breeds, a fair amount of mystery surrounds the exact origins of the Booted Bantam. Some historians trace the beginnings of the breed to Belgium in the 1800s. Others cite Dutch documents that reference small ornamental chickens with fully feathered hawks as far back as the 1600s. Belgian, German, Dutch, and English birds and breeders all appear to have played a role in the development of this breed. In the end, or rather the beginning, all Bantams have tropical origins, most likely from the jungles of Java. Characterized by abundant feathering on the feet and shanks, this little chicken looks to be wearing boots. Add to that the long, stiff, downward pointed feathers on the backs of the thighs, which are called the vulture hawks or sables in the Dutch language, and the origin of the names Booted Bantam and Sable Poot become clear. Popular for centuries in Europe, the breed is beloved in Germany and the Netherlands. The birds were present in the United States by 1836, and the white color variant was added to the American Standard of Perfection in 1879. Often mistaken for or confused with the Belgian bearded dackel, the Dutch Booted Bantam is believed to be one of the breeds used to create the Barbu dackel. However, there are differences in the two breeds. One major one being the Booted Bantam has no beard or earmuffs, but the bearded dackel does. The Booted Bantam has a short, compact body, short in the back and with the breast carried well forward. The upper line of the neck, back, and tail has a pronounced U shape. The legs have well-developed vulture hocks, long stiff feathers pointing down from the backs and thighs and almost reaching the ground. The shanks and feet are heavily feathered, particularly on the outer side. There are four toes. The wings are long and large and point downward at about the same angle as the vulture hocks. The comb is strong, single, and upright, with 5 to 7 points. The earlobes and wattles are red. The color of the beak varies according to the plumage. There are at least 33 defined color variants, of which 26 are recognized in Europe, 14 in the UK, and 5 in the US. Colors recognized in the US include the most popular color, Mille Fleurs, along with black, white, porcelain, and self blue. True Bantams, these tiny chickens, reach a maximum potential weight of 30 ounces for roosters and 27 ounces for hens. The American Poultry Society standards look for somewhat smaller birds with males no bigger than 26 ounces and females 22 ounces. Due to their diminutive size, Dutch Booted Bantams aren't particularly useful for meat or eggs and are typically kept for show or as pets. Hens do lay about 120 to 150 white to tinted very small eggs per year. This breed is well known as a great brooder, so if you need a little mama hen, these hens make a great option. Dutch Booted Bantams are often raised indoors or in protected coops with soft bedding to protect their delicate feathers. Additionally, these chickens aren't known for their hardiness and are particularly sensitive to cold. They are susceptible to many diseases, such as Merrick's disease, and require constant care to keep them healthy. While they may not be hardy, they are docile, calm, and friendly. If they're allowed access to range, they tend to be easier on the garden as their small size and feathered feet limit the damage that they can cause. But their small size also makes them excellent flyers as well as prime prey for many predators. So again, these birds are most often kept indoors as pets or for show. Just like hobby farm guy Eric, this breed is not a fan of the cold, not particularly hardy, and not a great producer of meat or eggs. But like hobby farm guy Eric, this little chicken earns its keep with its good looks and great personality. Quiet, calm, and easily handled, these chickens were made to be held and shown off. Their delicate good looks, wide range of potential colors, and dedicated breeder clubs have made this breed the supermodel of the chicken world. Let us know what you think by leaving a comment below. Also, we hope you'll consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to click the like button and to keep on hobby farming. Bye-bye.